Good afternoon, students at home. I'm happy to be back here to continue from where we stopped in the last class. Now, remember, I gave you some assignments in the last class, and I want to believe that you must have done some of those assignments. So, let me just try and give you answers to some of the ones that I feel you may have problem answering. One of the assignments I gave is to explain how the demand curve is derived from the marginality curve. And it's very simple. See, the only thing you need is to understand the law of demand. Then the law of diminished marginality. You see, the law of demand says that the lower the price of a given commodity, the higher the quantity demanded, and vice versa. Why the law of diminished marginality states that as more unit of a given commodity is consumed, the saturation derived diminishes. So as you are consuming more, your utility is falling. Which means that if you want to consume more, the price of that commodity you have to fall, because price always has to be equal to marginality for you to purchase, because that will refer to as equilibrium. Equilibrium is where your marginality is equal to price. So if as consumption increases, the utility falls, and price is equal to utility for consumption to take place, it simply means that for you to consume more, the price also must fall. So that's why the demand curve and the utility curve, they are downward sloping. The first one, utility curve, indicating that as more is consumed, utility falls. Why demand curve indicates that as price falls, the quantity demanded increases. So that's how to explain how the demand curve is derived from marginality curve. They also asked a question about utility maximization. I said, what are the conditions? There are two conditions. I've said the first one, where MU is equal to price. That's the first condition. The second condition is where MU S over price of S is equal to MUY over price of Y. So the marginality of unit of commodity is equal to all over the price is equal to marginality of unit of commodity Y all over the price. That's about that. Then I also asked about state the law of the marginality, which I've already explained. Now the concluding part of this topic is talking about consumer surplus. What do we mean by consumer surplus? The consumer surplus is the excess of the value of marginality over the price. See, when a consumer wants to purchase a commodity, there's a value that he places on that commodity before he purchases it, and that refers to the utility of that commodity. Now, if the value he places on it is higher than the price, then it's going to have what is called surplus. Surplus is just trying to explain the change, or more or less, the value he places on the commodity which is above the price. So the consumer is willing to pay more for that commodity, but eventually the price is lower. So he's going to go a situation where he's going to come back with a change. So for example, you have assumed the commodity should be maybe 1,005, and when you go to the market, the price is 1,000 naira, which means you are going back with a change of 500, which is your consumer surplus. So that is in concluding part of our discussion on utility. And then the consumer surplus is normally represented by the shading portion of the utility curve. See, a shaded portion of the utility curve gives us the consumer surplus. Now, you see, I want you to understand that there's a relationship between utility and demand curve. And that's why, after we have done utility, I also explained to you demand curve. They have a relation together. So I would advise you, go and read utility, then also study your demand curve. And then try and understand, from the question I gave you in the last class, try and understand the relationship, what they have in common. It's very, very important. So that in the next class, we'll now look at what is called the theory of supply. We'll look at the type of supply. We'll look at law of supply and every other under supply in the next class. So as an assignment, I would just like you to, with just the explanation I gave about consumer surplus now, draw the utility curve, marginality curve. After you have drawn the marginality curve, now it will look like a triangle. So cut half of it. When you cut it into half, then shade the upper part. That gives you the consumer surplus. Thank you very much. So I'll see you in the next class. Good afternoon.